Hey, Snout King here, and welcome to another episode. And when this goes up, it's gonna be the day after Christmas, so yeah, I hope you all had a nice Christmas. But this episode is gonna be different because I'm deciding to edit, edit this one, and edit it quite a bit, too. So, because we're doing a different kind of type of video. And, we're going to do Modern Warfare 3, because I'm not playing right now, I'm just talking over. Then there'll be a quick, gameplay in the background, but we're going to do Modern Warfare 3, survival, and we're going to do the equipment armory, the little, grenade thing, and all the stuff in there from worst to best. And then, after that, we're going to do air support armory, worst to best, as well, all the stuff in there, including the perks. So anyway, here we go. First thing is the equipment armory, and the worst thing in there, and in the equipment armory, there's actually everything in there is pretty solid, it's pretty good, and but the worst thing you can get, the least amount of value, the least thing that will help you survive per se, is probably the frag grenade, and it is the I believe it's the cheapest as well in the equipment armory. It's only $750 for it's only $750 for like a refill of frag grenades. And really, when you get into the later level, later waves, the frag stops killing people. They just does damage, and yes, it can kill once if it's like really close, but the frag grenade is not really it's not really that useful, because you know, it doesn't take out too many enemies, and and you only have a few of them too, so you can never really don't have enough, and and once you throw, you can't like run away, because you have a chance of running into your own frag grenade. So frag is kind of the worst thing. It's not bad though, just the worst value in the equipment, the worst item per se to get, but you still want to get them, because everything in the equipment is pretty good. That's why I like Modern Warfare 3 Survival. Now the next worst thing is the claymores, and yeah, I know, it's kind of surprised. Now, claymores can be really OP when you have 2 people, 20 claymores, right? Really good. Claymores can be, really good, but, you know, you can only, well, let's say single player, you can only have 10 claymores. That takes out 10 enemies, and you know, you don't want to be near your claymores, because when they go off, they can hurt you. So, you know, claymores are, you know, when you get into later rounds where you have, like, a lot of different enemies, like, a lot, claymore is just 10 enemies for how much, you know, 10 enemies for $2,000. Kills 10 enemies, and that isn't even, because when you get into higher rounds with the super buff guys, the claymores don't even take them out anymore, they just do damage. So yeah, claymores is the next value. The next worst thing is the flash grenade, and the reason why the flash grenade is above the claymore frag is simply because you can throw a flash, you're stuck in a room, yet your health is low, you're getting shot, just throw a flash, everyone in the room gets stuck, and you have your chance of opportunity to run the hell out of the room and survive. And the flash can be a clutch item in Modern Warfare 3 Survival. So that's why that's above the frag and the claymore. Now, the next worst is the RPG. Now, the RPG can be really good, you know, like, some people may put the RPG as the worst, but it's not, because it can easily take out juggernauts, and it can take out helicopters, you know, really quickly. But here's the problem with the RPG. The RPG, you can only, it's $2,000 for two missiles, and you can only hold a max of 4 missiles in the RPG. And on top of that, the RPG takes one of your slots. which is one of your gun slots, which is really unfortunate, you know? So instead of having like two, because when you get in later rounds, where you optimal way to play is having two LMGs with sleight of hand, but with an RPG, you have one LMG and an RPG with only four bullets in it, four missiles. So as you can tell, it becomes kind of useless, and then you kind of have a problem when you run out of ammo for your LMG, you know? That's why that's listed there. RPG is really nice for the beginning, though, but then again, it is very expensive for the beginning, so it's like 50-50. The next after the RPG is C4. Now, C4 is really good for just taking out juggernauts and just like planting them and in doorways. Reason why it's better than the claymores is simply because you have you can get juggernauts. They're coming through a doorway. You predict where they're gonna go. You throw 10 C4 down, and then once he walks through, you click it, and the juggernaut's dead. And you know it's probably one, except for the RPGs, probably one of the easiest ways to kill a juggernaut. But the difference is it doesn't take a slot for your gun, so C4 is pretty good. The next, but also C4 can kill you too, because you know enemies can actually shoot the C4. They don't try to, but if they can and it blows up, it can actually kill you. So, but that is really rare. The next up is the riot shield. Now, the reason the riot shield is better than the C4 RPG, flash grenade, claymore, and frag is that the riot shield, well, what do you think? It literally, it's like having body armor on, only and it deteriorates too. Now, the riot shield does take up one of your gun slots, which is a bummer, but it does actually protect you. And it protects your back as well if you have another weapon equipped. And yeah, and it's pretty good for the early game. Now, when you get into later game, yeah, it doesn't become so good late game, because just the sheer amount of gunfire that you'll be handling, your riot shield will break so quick, and you probably want the two LMGs, you know. But the riot shield does make it better than the RPG, because if you do run about out of ammo, you can pull out your riot shield, kill a guy with the riot shield, be protected, grab his gun, or with the riot shield, run to an ammo crate and grab ammo and be protected. And also, you can use the riot shield to run and get body armor or self-revive without taking too much damage. So riot shield, pretty good. The next best thing, the next thing that's better than the riot shield, this is my opinion, of course, just now, is the sentry gun. Yeah, so, well, the sentry gun, I was having a hard time deciding whether it was gonna be better than, let's say, the riot shield stuff. But you know, the sentry gun is really good because it acts like another AI. It's another thing for the enemies to shoot at. You can have it planted down, and you can take a breather. It takes out your enemies. Sometimes it draws the gunfire away from you, and it's really nice, you know. And if you have it planted in a good spot, it can take out a lot of enemies, a lot of enemies, if you have it planted in a good spot, of course. And then the next best thing is the grenade sentry, which is just a sentry, but it's honestly way better, because the amount of damage it does, and it gets so many more kills, and it has more health, I think. I'm not 100% sure on that, but the grenade sentry is really good. The only problem you worry about is the grenade sentry killing you, because if you're in, let's say, the map resistance, and you're in the home, and you have a grenade sentry set up, it can easily kill you. It can easily kill you. Just the grenade can shoot grenades near you, and you and yeah, so it's not best thing, but grenade sentry is better than the regular sentry, just because on one of the more open maps like Terminal, it just shreds like crazy. Okay, the next best thing is body armor. Well, you know, you get a bunch of extra hits to take, and it's like having like two more health bars, and You get to see what percentage your armor's at too, so you know when your armor's about to run out on, like, well, actually, never mind. But yeah, you can see the percentage of your armor, you know, you can tank a lot of hits from it, and it's really good. Like, you have, you're on top of the plane on terminal, you have body armor, a helicopter comes, helicopter starts to shoot its gun at you, burst at you, and then, you know, you would die if you didn't have that body armor on, because, you know, one full burst can kill you, but your body armor ends up saving you, and it's really clutch. Now the best thing in the equipment armory thing is self revive, because, well, I don't really have to explain it. It's like quick revive from Call of Duty Zombies on solo. It basically gives you another life, and you can buy it infinitely, rebuy infinitely for $1,000. Hell, you can even buy in middle of a round. You're on round 51, you die once, you self revive, you get self revived, you just run straight to the armory, buy another one. You die at the armory, you just buy a third one, then you just run out. You just have self revive, really good, really good. It's literally the most clutch thing you can buy in the entire Modern Warfare 3 survival mode. Thing, you know, the most clutch item you can buy. Okay, so that was for equipment armory, worst to best. Now, here we go to the air support armory from worst to best. Now, the worst thing in air support is quick draw, because, well, do I really have to explain that? From everything else compared to air support, quick draw just doesn't match up to everything else. Now, the next thing is steady aim. Well, also, you know, it just, you could say steady aim and quick draw belong in the same category. Actually, you could say quick draw is better than steady aim, but you could say steady aim is better than quick draw. It depends on you. But yeah, basically, quick draw and steady aim is reversible. Like, you can switch them, whatever. It's just equally as, like, good. Anyway, the next is the airstrike, because the airstrike is pretty good when you just throw a smoke grenade is where you want the airstrike, and takes out a lot of enemies, but you can't really be too precise with it, and, you know, sometimes you throw it and, like, it hits the missiles start hitting a bunch of things you don't want to hit, and then it's not the best thing, but it's pretty good. The next one is extreme conditioning. Who doesn't like running away from things? Combine that with the flash grenade from earlier, and that's a really good clutch setup right there. You just can get the hell out. The next is stalker, because who doesn't want ammo? Actually, it's really good, because when you run out of ammo, well, you just kill some guy right next to you, and you just get a bunch more. Stalker is really good. Predator missiles, the next, well, because, hey, you want to take out a juggernaut round comes immediately, give predator missile, just take them out instantly. Yeah, predator missile or helicopter. Predator missile is really good, actually, in Modern Warfare 3 survival. The next one is Delta Squad. What can you say? You just have a bunch of AIs who deal damage to enemies and take the gunfire away from you. Almost acts like the sentry, but it's actually a little better than the sentry, because they can move and take out more enemies. And, you know, they're a bunch. There's like four of them and four different AIs for the enemies to shoot at instead of shooting at you. So it's nice. You know, you're on a round 53, you're dying, but you just call in a Delta Squad, and they can come in for you and, you know, clear the room, and basically, you can run to ammo, you can get your ammo back while the Delta Squad is taking care of things, and, you know, they may die in the process, because they die easily, but they can become clutch, because they can just provide you with just enough time for you to re-equip and, you know, stuff like that. Now, the next one is Riot Shield Squad. Riot Shield Squad is really good. You know, they have riot shields, they're protected, and they can use machine guns, assault rifles. So they deal a lot of damage, they draw away enemy fire from you, and they are hard to kill. On juggernaut rounds, they will die instantly, yes, but on any other round, you know, they're pretty hard to kill and they can survive. I mean, like, I remember on like round 60, they can survive 3 rounds straight. Right, shield squad, crazy. And the next best, or the best in air support, is definitely sleight of hand. Because, you know, the go-to combo is 2 LMGs, and with sleight of hand, you basically are never, you just never stop firing, you know. It's like speed colon Call of Duty Zombies. Like, when you get into those high rounds of Call of Duty Zombies, you cannot stop firing. I mean, you train, yes, but it's more important in Modern Warfare 3 Survival. You just shoot. Like, you just have to shoot. And basically, that's where sleight of hand comes in. And, yeah, sleight of hand, Stalker perk, and Riot Shield Squad with 2 grenade sentries. You know, that's like, that's basically like the god tier loadout for Modern Warfare 3 Survival. And yeah, that has been my video of air support and equipment armory of worst to best. And you know, I support, and you know, I do edit a lot, get the gameplay, all that stuff. And let me just really quickly, so you know, in case you want to hear, I'm not gonna show gameplay of this specifically, it'll just be random gameplay in the background, but let me go through the worst to best armory loadouts or armory categories of weapon armory, whatever, you know, like a SARI or submachine gun, all that. So the worst one is probably, I mean, this is my opinion, but probably sniper rifles. You know, it's just, you know, single shot, you know, and you need to take out a lot of, there's a lot of guys to take out. So I would say sniper rifles the worst. And then the next comes probably shotguns. It's for the later rounds, shotguns, you know. Then the next comes, I would say, handguns. And then the next, machine pistols. And then the next would be submachine guns, then assault rifles, and then light machine guns. And that's my, and the best being light machine guns, obviously, like 2 LMGs, that's what you want. And yeah, that's my, that is my, video, you know, all the 3 armory equipment, air support equipment, and weapon armory, whatever, worst to best. And yeah, that has been Snout King, and see you.